Well, more than 200 workers at the Sydney factory that produces Huggies nappies will be out of a job within months after owner Kimberly Clark announced it's moving production to Asia. For more on this, we're joined by Nine Finance editor Ross Greenwood. Ross, good morning to you.
Good morning, Georgie.
Another blow to Australia's manufacturing industry. What is behind this decision?
Well, look, the truth of the matter is that Kimberly Clark worldwide has said it was closing down 10 factories. And the truth is they're looking around the world to figure out where their cost bases are too high. They're looking at Australia. It's too expensive, they think, to make those nappies here in Australia. It's interesting to note off their website, it says Huggies Nappies, Australia's number one nappy, has been taking care of babies' bottoms for decades. Well, I can tell you their workers' bottoms are really out the back of their trousers this morning because they have left them in a significant hole. I feel really sad for the workers here because this is the reality of Australia today. Wages are becoming too expensive and multinational companies with, you know, not only the cost of wages but also the cost of energy as well are shipping jobs offshore. Now, in this particular case, what do these workers do now? I mean, the fact of the matter is many of these workers doing radio last night, people were ringing me say they're highly skilled. They've got really very technical skills to be able to, you know, work this equipment. And so now if some of these jobs could be earning $120,000 or even more, where do they go?
So does the government need to step in and protect these Australian jobs?
How can they? How can the government do this?
Well, it's been done before.
Well, do you actually pay money to the company to keep it here? That's not what we're about. But the fact of the matter is that in the future, you know, there are more jobs like this that really have question marks over them. For example, in this particular case, Kimberly Clark has got another plant that employs even more people in South Australia at Millicent. Now, it makes Kleenex tissues and also makes Viva. There are its other brands. And those workers had to go through a four-year battle to get an enterprise bargaining agreement basically signed last year. It was a massive battle between the unions, even though they're all sort of trying to agree to cut costs and get things done. Now, they finally did that deal. But in this case, on this particular plant which is being closed, the enterprise bargaining agreement was due up this year. And so this is all a battle about wages, but it's also a battle about international companies having choices to where they make things. And if Australia's too expensive, then those things won't be made here in Australia anymore.
Just quickly and finally, obviously concern also from parents who buy the products who are suggesting that this is going to see the cost of nappies go up and it's also going to potentially impact safety standards.
Well, the safety standards things I don't buy, and the reason for that is mainly because they've got to make them to Australian standards. Now, I will say there has been a Facebook group in recent times worried about the leakage of the Huggies nappies. So that's been out there, I will say that. But the other thing, they do have to comply with Australian standards. The second thing in terms of nappy prices going up, remember the reason why the company is doing this. It wants to find cheaper solutions to try and be able to keep the prices down. So it also goes back to your supermarket and the supply agreements that they have got with companies like Kimberly Clark, because remember the supermarkets are continuing to put pressure on these companies to keep the prices down. It's a little like the milk, if you like. It all goes around in circles, this thing. But the sad part about it is those 220 families now have to make decisions about their future, and they really shouldn't be in this position.
No. All right. Thank you for your insight, Ross.